Hey guys, just welcome to my ProBuild YouTube channel. So today I'll be discussing you with this part. Actually, this is pinch fit cap. Actually, it looks very cool and it's very easy also. So I'm going to do it in this PTC Creo 7.0 version. So just before going into 3D, I need to go up with this all orthographic view. So here they have given the front view and side view. So in side view all the complete major data has been furnished, and in front view the data for the base part alone has been furnished. So I'm going to start with this. So it's R40 and R22.5. it is extruded up to 75. So I'm going to choose my front plane and go for extrude. I'm going to draw R40 and R22.5. So this is R40 in the sense it is 80 in circle's diameter, and 22.5 into 2 is going to be the circle diameter. And now this is going to be extruded for 75. So it's all done. So change this view to shading with edges. Now I'm going for this view once again. Here you can find a slope of 45 degree. I mean actually it's removing the material here. Actually this shape, this can be obtained by this right side view. So just go for extrude and change this view to horizontal plane and just click on this line. Now change this view to hidden line so that everything is available. Now from base this is going to be 45 degree, and this slant line is going to extend, start from 40th point. So actually this is from base, I guess, right? Okay, so I'm going for reference, just mark this as my base. Now I'm going to draw a line, I'm going to draw a reference line, change this point to reference. This is going to be my reference, and now click on the fixed dimensions, change this to 40, and from here I'm going to draw a line stating this angle from this point is going to be 45. Now make a closed loop so that it can be removed. So just go for symmetry, drag all the way and click on this material, remove. So my side part is ready. Now change this view to shading with edges. I need to go up with round first so that it would be easier for me. So actually this is R12 and remaining it's given here, all fillets 3 mm unless otherwise noted. So at this point alone it is R12, so I'm going for round and click this point, change this to 12 and even this. Now just go for sets, add a set and click on one edge, change this to 3 mm and change all the remaining edges related to this 3 mm. Okay, it's all done. So now click OK. So my complete base part is ready now, and my final target is to insert this second part. It is just coinciding very tangentially to my base part. So its detail is given in this view. So we can see here a circle of 12.5 mm, and it is given from here, that is from center to the top quadrant of that second part is going to be 55. So, and the part is going to be start from, yeah, okay, here. So I'm going to choose the same right plane and go for extrude once again. Change this view, and important is to change this to hidden line so that you can see inside. The main purpose is to see this thickness. Okay, so I'm going to draw a circle. This is going to be 12.5 × 2. Since they have given only the radius, you can find here this is actually radius. It's stated here that is R 12.5. so from offset, from this end surface, it is offset to 7.5. so go for dimension. From here to here is going to be 7.5. okay, now from bottom, from top to center is going to be 55. So from top to this center is going to be 55. And from center to this edge is going to be 20. Actually, I have given this center, actually this is wrong. This 7.5 doesn't mean that. And from center to this line is actually 20. From this point to here is actually 7.50, and it is already understood by the system that it must be 7.50. so no problem. So I'm going to draw a line all the way down just for connecting, up to this possible thickness I can draw a line. So I'm going to draw a line up to this possible thickness. Now go for delete segment. So from here I just made, and this part shall be extruded up to 65. So I'm going for symmetry, change this to 65. Just make sure that this end part is not living alone, so that again go for placement, edit, change this to 2D view, and just decrease this height so that I'm changing to 23.0 so that it completely coincides with the part. Okay, it's all done. Just click on OK. Now just my final is going to be this hole. Actually, this is C bore, and its data is given here. So 15 is going to be the 15 mm is going to be my first circle, and the hole is going to be of dia 9 and 8 mm offset. So just go for an hole, click on the surface, and in simple standard just click this C bore, and in shape change this to 15 and this to 9 and this as 8 as given, and change this to up to selected surface and change this. Okay, now I'm going to plot here my clip. So just go for placement. Now from here I'm going to click on this plane so that this value, I know already it is 55 minus 12.5, and this one I need to align with this side surface. This is 20 as given. So you can see the hole. Just click OK. Now, just my final touch is going to be round. I want to take a slot here. Here the slot is actually 3 mm. So just go again with this view, go to extrude and draw one simple rectangle just connecting here and go for symmetry. Change this to 3 mm and just remove the material. So my slot is ready. Now change this view to shading with edges. I want to keep here as fillet 3, so change to 3 as all possible edges. So this edge, even this edge, so it's all done. Now I'm going to change the color. So go for view, appearances, and select golden color, any one color which you like, and go for reality view. So my part is ready. So thank you for seeing my video. So please do subscribe my channel for just learning all the complex exercises and simple exercises as well in PTC Creo and AutoCAD. So thank you for watching my video. Bye.